Hello everybody, welcome to our new video. Today we're going to fix some error which said sorry, no product matched your selection. Please choose a different combination. Okay, this error is for instance, I was creating some list of perfumes. I want if somebody come here and select any perfume, it should look like this. If I select this perfume and also maybe say two, then I can add to cart. I don't have to get any problems, so I can find that I've got, you can see four in cart here. I can delete this. I delete this. Let me see. I delete also this. I can refresh the page and I do something else also. I come here and this only works if you did put variations on your on your product. So you can see everything is working fine, but now before I was getting an error which says like this. You can see also I was researching here on this error. It says sorry, no product matched you, whatever. So this thing, since I've fixed it, I don't want to mess up everything, but I'm gonna show you how to fix it so that also you manage to fix your stuff that side. So for instance, for now, most people, they use simple products. Simple product, just know you can just set here, and in simple product, if you don't set any money and you save if you save like this, I want to save. Yes, I'm saving. I've saved and I'm gonna click here. A little bit slow, but it's gonna be fine. If I press here, it gives me product currently out of stock. It tells me that because I did not set the stock anyway. On simple products, you can set stock. But anyway, we can set stock if you want to do so, but if we don't want to do so, also we can find a way to do that so that it doesn't give us that error. Enable stock management here. If you want to do that, you can. Let's do simple products here, and we say maybe it's gonna be 100 rands each, and we save. Once we save that, we can see that once we save that, we're gonna see if we find anything here. It says out of stock, but at least it tells you some money. That shouldn't be a problem here. We can come down here and we go to what they call variations here. Save variations. Okay, we're going to use product that what we set already. We come and save variations here. So the reason why we're getting that problem is that you did not do what? Okay, if I save variations and I save, let's see the behavior here. Once we're done with that, we're not using simple product. You can see product currently out of stock. While we're saying this, because we did not also set that, don't worry about that. We're gonna come back and we fix everything right. So here we can choose this, and also we click on variations here. Since we're there, we can say go there, add variations. So since we're going to add variation, you can see that we had it before, but now once we save, you're gonna see the problem we're gonna have. Then once we save, wait, and I refresh. Okay, you see out of stock, no stress. Out of stock, leave that, that's gonna go, that's not something important, something much of a stress. That's something I'm gonna fix, and I fixed that in a video earlier. So shouldn't take us time to do that. So if we say we're using variable product and we say variations, and okay, if you say can go to inventory, and you okay, this is enable stock management, we can do that. And we say we want to make this to be quantity, we have maybe 1,000 in stock. After that, we can save our stuff, we can still save this. After saving that, you refresh here. Unable to. Okay. That's not a stress also to me. Okay, step by step, guys, don't lose hope or don't lose track, be on track. We're gonna see how this error is gonna be fixed. Okay, we did put this, and we can go click here, and we save variation. Any, okay. One variation does not have price. Okay, we click here, and we can say enable stock. If we say enable stock, we can say quantity, we have 1,000. I deliberately want to get one error for you so that you see what we're fixing. I want to, so that's why I'm setting a stock here only. And don't set other stuff. I'm saving. Okay. Trying to do something wrong to get you onto that error, which is giving you a tough time. So stock management, can do that away. We have these attributes, okay, already. Then you say variation, and variation, so you can then select what they call status, advanced pricing, inventory, okay, stock, yes. When I say stock, say go, enter value, we're gonna say we have 1,000, and we say okay. Once we say okay, we save everything and we come. Okay, here and we update here. After updating, we're going to see something. Still we're getting that error, which I don't want to do. Patience. We're using this. We using variation. Okay, we can click on here. We want to expand. Okay, once we expand, we know we have 1,000. Okay. We'll say any. And let's allow that. Let's see where it's gonna take us. Okay, let's fix the error before. Let me show you to fix the error once. That error which says, sorry, no product matched. So what you got to do is you go here. You know you're going to use, you're not going to use simple product. You're going to use this. Then you can go to your attributes, which are these. We already used these attributes. Okay. We don't want to add any. So you go to variations here. Then when you're there, you can click on expand this. Once you expand that, you must put in your money. So I'm going to sell it 100 rands, not 1,100 rands. So after putting that, simple parents, it should work for you, because if you don't set up this, it's going to tell you that there's no, sorry, no product matched your selection. So once you put in that money, you can save. Remember before we, before we do anything, we got to understand that here, let's see here, there's nothing here, but if after fixing, you can see everything came back. You can say, I can select, say 1,000 in stock. You can see, yeah, guys, that's the way how to fix. You saw before there was no button for selecting, so now there's a button for selecting. The only thing, the problem which causes that error is what is, it says no product matched is when you did not set up your how much you're selling the product. So you can see I put it on 100, that's why you can see you have it there. So also you can take out that stock thing so that you don't want to know how much stock you have. Maybe something, maybe a service which you never, which has unlimited stock. We can go to variations and we go here back and click here. We expand this, click now, we expand this. So you remove this stock management and also you untick here. After when you untick here, because we're not using a simple product, we're using this variable product. So after that you can save. After saving, you can go and update here. After when you have updated, this stock should go away and you start making your sales well. You see there's no stock now, no more. Once you select any, it means you have unlimited stock. And I can add to cart now. You can see I've added one, so I didn't get any problems anyway. Yeah, guys, thanks for watching. See you in the next video. I hope this helped. And if you have any question, please ask me. I'm gonna respond to you as soon as I can. So the error said, sorry, no product matched select your selection. So simply means you must set up your fees, your prices. The problem is on your prices. You can either change it and put sales and also the actual price, whatever you want. But if there's zeros there, it's gonna give you that error. It's gonna throw up to you an error. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video.